Hey guys, this is Diplosteg here with another review, and today we are going to be looking at the Scheilch conquering the land Kentorsaurus. I recently got this in my Christmas haul with four other figures. If you haven't seen that video, please check it out. Starting with a few quick facts about Kentorsaurus. It was a genus of stegosaurian dinosaur that lived in Tanzania, if you're an evolutionist, in the late Jurassic period, and the types of species, or the only species, is Aethiopicus, Kentorsaurus Aethiopicus, and it is closely related to Stegosaurus, which lived in the Morrison Formation of western North America. It was found in 1915, and it was named by and found by a man named Heinig. I couldn't get his first name, but he was a German paleontologist. And it's thought to be a more primitive stegosaurian. And it was 1 ton, and it was 15 feet long. And it actually wasn't too much taller than a human. So it was relatively small for its size. And that is the facts for it. And another thing, one more thing. It was a small stegosaur considering the stegosaur family. And most stegosaurs are characterized by small heads, plates, spikes, and just a long tail. But yeah, back to the model. The model is really great. I love the detailing on it. This is one of the Scheilch models that I like. This is my third Scheilch model, actually. I think the paint scheme is a bit dull. I wish they would have done more with it. Maybe make it more elaborate. This is a female Kentrosaurus, because in dinosaur world, the males predominantly were more colorful. That is what is thought to be the case today. And the females were more dull. But yeah, I don't know. I think they could have made it more eye-popping. But I think it's more of like a rustic kind of figure, if you get what I'm saying. But yeah, let's just look at the model and the detail. The scales are really nice. The muscle on the legs is stunning. There's a bit of webbing there between the legs and the stomach. There's the tiny head. You can see the eye. And the beak. Going up, you can see the plates slash spikes. I'm gonna turn this around. My camera will get there. There we go. So that's another view from the back. You can see those large spikes protruding out of the shoulders. Again, nice detail. The only problem I had with this figure is this right here, that plate, was bent all the way down, and I had to warm it up and fix it. And it's still a little bit like that. I just have to warm it up more with a blow dryer or some warm water. Next up, let's do a front view. There it is right there. I like that pose a lot, just kind of looking at the camera there, checking things out. And then from this side, walking away, or maybe getting into a defense position. I think the pose of it is really, really nice. It's kind of warning another dinosaur to back off, maybe like an Allosaurus or Ceratosaurus. But yeah, let me zoom out a bit. There we go. It's a relatively tiny figure. It's probably 2 inches tall, maybe 3. at the tip of the tail. But yeah, now it's time for some size comparisons. Starting off with two other Schleich figures, the Schleich Apatosaurus. Here. It's a reach. Schleich Apatosaurus and the Schleich Peniceratops. They dwarf this guy. It's funny. I wish this was a bit bigger, but considering the size of Kentorsaurus, I think that Schleich did an accurate job. I don't see any inaccuracies with it. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. But yeah, I think they scale well together, and I think they look nice together. Get these two out of the way. And next up is the Papostegosaurus, which is actually being retired, or at least this paint scheme, which I'm kind of sad about, because this is one of my favorite stegosaur models. So there's that. And then next up is the Safari version, new for 2019. Oh, there we go. But yeah, I think that they all scale really nice. I think that the Papo version scales, or not scales, but looks the best with it. Just two stegosaurs. Papo has more of like a really kind of gritty, realistic look. Safari does have the realistic look as well, but it just looks different in my opinion. But yeah, that has been my review for the Schleich Conquering the Land Kentrosaurus. I really like this figure. I give it a 4 out of 5 stars just because of the paint scheme. I mean, I think they could have done a better job making it pop. But yeah, I hope you guys liked it. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.